In the previous video, I had made a change to the storage tank by creating a new version of the storage tank element. And in that new version, I specified a new height and a new product. So how would I go back and see the previous? And also, how would I bring back my mixing tank or my storage tank 2? If you recall, in the previous video, storage tank 2 I made obsolete as of 1st of October. So how would I go back and find that again? Well, I would do that by setting the query date. So I'm going to make a change to this query date. We should look for two things. We should see this storage tank 2 reappears. We should also see in storage tank 1, this should go back to the previous height and the previous product. Let me go ahead and change the query date. I'll just set this back to, let's say, the 15th of September. Let's take a look at our results. Yeah, here's our storage tank 2. Storage tank 2 has been restored, so the obsolete date, as you can see, is still in the future relative to this, which is my query date. So as you can see, we put in the title bar what the query date is. If the query date goes after 1st of October, that disappears. And if we go back and look at storage tank 1, we're back to the original height, 10 meters, and this was the original product. Now, like many of our user interfaces, you'll find a little drop down here that gives you some shortcuts, including two I think that really require some explanation. Well, set today is pretty straightforward. Today just means today as of midnight. That's pretty straightforward. Today as of midnight, that storage tank 2 is still gone. But then there's this set to now and set to latest. And let me just show you the difference between the two. Set to now is showing me as of right now what values, but set to latest is showing me as of the latest versions. And why would there be a difference? Well, if there are versions that are, well, do not have an effective date until the future, by choosing set to latest, you'll actually see, you know, those AF elements that are yet to come on board, more or less. So setting to latest will increment this or set the query date to show all the latest versions, well, at least the ones that are not obsolete. As you see, we still don't see storage tank 2 here. Now, that is the default behavior, the set to latest. So normally you will see the latest version of everything, even stuff that has not yet had its effective date in the past yet. If you choose set to now, we will show you the time up here, and that essentially means everything that is in effect as of now, but it will not include things that may be coming on later with an effective date in the future. By the way, just to round out this topic, you know, how would I go back and bring back my storage tank 2 so that I can see it in real time instead of having to keep going back to my query date back before the 1st? That's real simple. I'll just go into storage tank 2 into version, and let me change this and eliminate this obsolete date. So I'll go ahead and check this in. Once I've no longer established that that's obsolete, then if I go ahead and set this to the current time, as you can see, we're back where we were originally. We see both storage tanks. Yeah, there we go. So our storage tanks will appear because they're no longer set obsolete, this particular version or that particular AF element.